The phase right now in Bollywood is one of the most depressing phases. You are a youth icon, people look up to you, and if you're not responsible enough to learn from your past mistakes, it's shameful. We don't give a damn for the ones who write, the ones who compose, for a genuine singer, because everybody wants to do everybody else's job. This song of mine incidentally features Rajkumar Rao, who's one of my favorite actors, you know, but this was his first release when he was still a student in FTII. Reality shows mein bhi sab lachari ko hi highlight karte rehte hain. Truth is, ye reality, ye it's all bullshit. Babul pyare sajan sakhare suno meri maiya, bojh nahi main kisi ke sar ka na majdhar mein naiya, patwar banungi लहरों से लड़ूंगी, अरे मुझे क्या बेचेगा रुपया, हो हो, अरे मुझे क्या बेचेगा रुपया।
Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get updates.
She has been winning our hearts with her powerful and encouraging songs. She is also known for speaking her mind and for courageously standing for what's right, and is now receiving accolades for her recently released Bengali songs. It's none other than Sona Mohapatra with us today. Hello Sona, welcome to India Forums.
Happy to be here. So my latest song, which is Mon Ke Bajaye Tere Dware, it is a combination of a Bengali folk kind of a genre with a Qawwali, which is also very, very special because it features a young, upcoming, very, very talented young artist called Sahil Solanki. Sahil se main mili thi when I was a judge on Saregama Pa on ZTV, and I had chosen him to be in the top 5 of my team, you know, representing my team and my spirit. And to feature him on the song was a very, very special experience because reality shows mein बहुत कुछ जो दिखता है वो इट डजेंट गो बियॉन्ड द शो, एंड आई फाइंड दैट हार्ट ब्रेकिंग बिकॉज आई फील म्यूजिक मेंटरशिप एवरीथिंग हैज़ टू हैव समथिंग दैट गोज बियॉन्ड द 2 or 3 मंथ्स दैट यू आर विद पीपल. सो आई गॉट अ चांस यू नो, एंड आई जस्ट ग्रैब्ड इट एंड ही वॉज एक्सलेंट एंड एवरीबडी. इनफैक्ट अगर आप कॉमेंट सेक्शन में देखो, पीपल हैव लव्ड हिज परफॉर्मेंस एंड आई इट मेक्स मी वेरी वेरी हैप्पी. And ये भी सुनने को मिला है कि the song is already started getting picked up amongst the people outside of our country. So that's very interesting because again music has no language, and right now from cinema में अगर देखो, Bahubali came and wowed everybody. It didn't come from either the regular Bollywood actors or a language or a idiom that we are familiar with in a national space, but it is the biggest grosser. I think जो phase चल रहा है it is exciting. I don't think it is linked, but as a musician I want to comment on the fact that the phase right now in Bollywood is one of the most depressing phases when it comes to music. Absolutely the most depressing phase, because songs just keep getting remixed, nothing new seems to be getting actioned off by producers, except for a few exceptions like a Sanjay Leela Bhansali film will always have new music, will have enough number of female songs. Razi had good music in 2018, which was again original songs, but otherwise everybody is either picking up some Punjabi hit track and forcing it into a film, which has no place in it, force fit ho jata hai, ya koi purane gaane ko remix kar lete hain with where they don't even put the name of the original composer or the artist, and that's in a sense it's a very heartbreaking, despondent phase for the whole music community and the music industry, because the message that seems to be given to us is like kuch naya banane ki zarurat hi nahi hai, jitne gaane bane hain wo ban chuke hain, all the music in the world has been made, and now the few labels, music labels that we have, is they are just going to library में जो है उसको बार बार उसी गाने को अलग अलग तरीके से रिलीज़ कर रहे हैं, एंड मोर ऑफन देन नॉट दे आर टेरेबल वर्जन्स ऑफ द ओरिजिनल सॉन्ग्स. सो समटाइम्स अ सॉन्ग गेट्स अ ब्रांड न्यू लाइफ बिकॉज यू टेक इट फ्रॉम अनदर ईरा एंड प्रेजेंट इट टू अ न्यू जनरेशन, बट बॉलीवुड इज़ नॉट रियली डूइंग अ ग्रेट जॉब ऑफ इट राइट नाउ. दैट इज़ हाउ आई फील, विच इज़ वाई द ओरिप्लास्ट ओरिजिनल्स इज सच अ ग्रेट ग्रेट इनिशिएटिव, बिकॉज देर आर अ लाइन अप ऑफ मैनी मैनी यू नो अपकमिंग आर्टिस्ट, न्यू कम्पोजर्स एंड एस्टैब्लिश्ड यू नो स्टार्स हु हैव कम टुगेदर इन अ कोलैबोरेटिव प्लेटफॉर्म. देर इज़ द जॉय ऑफ अ वेरी सिंपल सेटिंग विच इज़ लाइव म्यूजिशंस, अ बैंड प्लेइंग एंड जस्ट अ सिंपल परफॉर्मेंस वीडियो, एंड आई थिंक it goes to say with the results that have already come in that I think India is starved, our subcontinent is starved for good music when it comes to rootsy, authentic, real, original music, you know, music which doesn't necessarily have to have the grandest of picturizations or people, 100 people dancing on it. So I'm very proud to be part of that platform, you know. So
do you think we need to have one collaborative platform where we have all the languages, all the different kind of folk songs? Do you think that is required right now?
We don't need one, we need hundreds. And actually the bands that I am a huge fan of across the country, Thaikudam Bridge, for example, is a band from the south. They play their own language, they sing in Malayali and they are fantastic. And they have huge fans, numbers and numbers of fans, even in Bombay, even in the north. So again, they don't sing in a language that people understand, but they managed to find an audience. Just that it is unlikely that maybe the average person following India Forums has heard of Thaikudam Bridge, but they have found their fans and music finds their fans. And I think thank goodness for the internet right now that we don't have somebody sitting in a music label only deciding that हमको सिर्फ डांस गाने चाहिए. मेरा जब एक गाना रिलीज हुआ था, यू कैन सी द पिक्चर हियर समवेयर, आजावे यहाँ पे कहीं अटका था. दैट इज़ अ दिस सॉन्ग ऑफ माइन इंसिडेंटली फीचर्स राजकुमार राव, हु इज वन ऑफ माई फेवरेट एक्टर्स, यू नो. बट दिस वॉज हिज फर्स्ट रिलीज वेन ही वॉज स्टिल अ स्टूडेंट इन FTII. सो दिस सॉन्ग इज अ सॉन्ग वेयर वी हैव शॉट ऑल अराउंड द विलेजेस ऑफ महाराष्ट्र. एवरी टाइम द सॉन्ग प्लेज पीपल्स आर डांसिंग. And I'm wearing a dhoti, I'm wearing a shirt rolled up. And that point of time, everybody in Bombay was telling me, अरे इस गाने को आप डिस्को में शूट करते, or you know, that was the trend then. Everybody is dancing in a disco. तब और भी बड़ा हिट होता. Truth is, it has stood the test of time. It has personality. It stands for what the music or the music artist wants to say to the public. And I get to perform so much for my audiences across the country, across the world, because I perform in concert and I see myself as a performing artist more than anything else. And times have changed, fortunately, क्योंकि I think I did the right thing. आजावे को जैसे शूट किया था वही सही था. डिस्को में ला के डाल देते तो मार देते गाने को. तो I feel it's important that right now we, celebrate, artists with personalities who have something to say, not just who are here to follow the latest trend, you know. So
one thing you think according to you that the music industry desperately needs to change, you know, to grow or to nourish, one thing that you think?
One is we need to start by having a music industry. Till now the music industry has always been a part of the film industry and it has served the purpose for the promotion of films, which is great. It is a very important means by which some of the greatest of poetry and music has been released via Bollywood. So I am a huge fan of that. When we met Gulzar Saab, we met the all-time greats of our industry thanks to Bollywood. But what needs to change right now for sure is a very, very simple thing. A respect for creation, a respect for creators. Because right now the message that is being given out is we don't give a damn for the ones who write, the ones who compose, for a genuine singer. Because everybody wants to do everybody else's job, you know, which I find very disturbing. What a great singer does is a lifetime of riyaz, a lifetime of working towards delivering a song. But since the singers have taken away all the glory and have been the face of it, it apparently seems that it is right that the composers wanted to sing all the singers' songs and singers were kept aside. Now there are no composers required because the music labels and producers are just wanting to take old songs and remix it. They give it to some arranger saying ek beat dal do, ek rap dal do aur gana naya ban gaya. So they don't care about wanting to. So the pride that you have in every generation saying we want to create new things that leave behind a legacy, that pride needs to come back. And the whole industry needs to feel the pinch that we can't be creating a phase where we are not having the guts to back new stuff, you know, that we are operating out of fear, that we just need to take the safest thing as long as somehow we do our job and make some money. So it is a depressing, the worst phase, I feel, in terms of the music industry. But for artists like me And for my whole fraternity, for my whole community, I think it's a great opportunity. It's an opportunity to say we are not waiting desperately for a break, waiting for somebody else to do all the hard job and us getting an overnight hit and then suddenly making millions. It's time for us to invest in our own music, in our own artistry, backing our own self, making our own teams, making our own little world where we take responsibility to put out this music, find ways to do it, because the internet lets you do it. You know, build your YouTube channel, be talking to your audience on Facebook. It's an everyday hustle, it's an everyday job, and it's something I've been doing for over 10 years, and I have gotten huge rewards and I have gotten huge dividends from committing to my audience and to my music and not depending on one person to make me rich overnight. So that is the one thing that I feel that's the one message I would like to put out to anybody listening, that things are in your own hands. You can really pretty much be part of the change instead of waiting for some big udhar to happen from somewhere.
Also, Sona, you know, you're known for speaking your mind when it comes to social media. Mm-hmm. And recently, social media has been trolling and slamming celebrities left, right, center. Mm-hmm. The recent one to be Priyanka Chopra, if you must have followed. She got trolled and slammed
for
her picture on the yard of smoking picture.
Okay, I'm not aware of that.
Okay, and recently the reason was for that was because she, last Diwali, she was promoting No Smoke Diwali. Mm-hmm. And then she was spotted smoking and then you find
it. Not connected to me or the music. So honestly, when I speak out on social media, mm-hmm. I speak out very spontaneously. I speak out on issues that are affecting a larger psyche of a country. I stand for certain things and a certain value and belief system, and I feel mass media as well as cinema and stars and narratives which come from, they play a big role in shaping how a whole country thinks and behaves. So if you're going to show extreme sexist behavior, music that promotes stalking women, yeah. misbehaving with them, chhedchhad, if that's going to, you're going to normalize that behavior. If you're going to normalize and romanticize and glorify behavior that is very dangerous, it has a very big impact on the youth of the country because they consume all this and it plays a very big role in, and we actually literally see it changing in the way we are treated when you're traveling in the country. There's been a very, very healthy shift in the last 10 years, even as a traveling musician, I've noticed. Because of the fact that we are having all these debates and conversations and fights on social media, my audience is very clued in to what I talk about. And while I get slammed very often for being in a controversy every 2 months, when I'm in the middle of it, it's not easy. You think, why are you making enemies? Why are you pissing off so many people in the industry? But overall, if it is creating a conversation which is going towards a better, a change, I think it's all worth it. I think it's, and you know, I've heard that most of the shooting sets now, from Netflix to Amazon, all the big setups which are spending a lot of money creating content, have a system in place where they put out forms for the crew members, not only just the actors and the people, and for the crew members, you know, you don't come to know about the makeup artists and the ADs and several people who go through a lot of harassment on the sets, who now have a number and an email on which they can write into if they experience any hanky-panky behavior, you know, behavior that makes them uncomfortable or which is in some way sexist or harassment. So somewhere a shift has happened. So when somebody tells me, wo sab karke kya hua, wo to abhi bhi Anu Malik ja raha hai judge banke, bhai lekin baatcheet to hui, you know, and Kailash Kher is performing in big government mahotsavs. The truth is, nothing is going to happen overnight. Nobody is sitting there with a black and white book where you can decide, you know what, but overall there's an awareness that has been created, there's a discussion that is happening, and it's a long run. So I think it's very healthy. All these discussions are very healthy.
Also, recently you put up a very strong point related after Vikas Bahl was left given a clean chit. So would you like to add something to that?
I don't think he's been given a clean chit. It was a process followed for that particular film to get released. And it was a very lopsided process. That way we can talk about even the Chief Justice of India, who, if you see how the proceedings went there, that also seems very lopsided. But I have immense faith. The good thing is I have, यू नो वन इज़ यू कैन फील डिस्पेयर एंड यू कैन फील डिस्पॉन्डेंसी थिंकिंग कुछ तो नहीं हो रहा ऑल दीज पीपल आर गेटिंग अवे विद अ क्लीन चिट आई डोंट थिंक इट्स अ क्लीन चिट टू स्टार्ट विथ अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल वर्क टूवर्ड्स मेकिंग अ फिल्म हैपन वेन वी मेक वन म्यूजिक वीडियो वी सी 100 पीपल सफर बिफोर इट गेट्स डन सो वेन अ फिल्म इज मेड देर आर हंड्रेड्स ऑफ पीपल हु हेल्प क्रिएट अ फिल्म एंड देर आर लॉट ऑफ लीगैलिटीज विच somebody can twist around to make sure their name is there and they get credit but doesn't mean he's got a clean chit that the film got released is somebody got in touch with me can we have a campaign against the release of the film 30 I said no I mean that's not my idea why should I'm not here to create trouble why should we be coming in the way of releasing that film 100 other people have put their sweat and blood in making that film and we are not here to come in the way of other people's work but at the same time that kind of behavior should not be encouraged and that there should be an awareness that is absolutely wrong and if you indulge in that behavior there will be consequences you know I don't think Vikas Behl must be having a good night's sleep as will a Kailash Kher or as will a Anu Malik all of them grinning in front of the cameras are not necessarily having the best time and the idea is not to permanently put people out of work or none of that the thing is for us to create a positive change and not let people get away with and actions have to have consequences not all of them can go through the legal route there are people who ask me that why would we cannot take everything to the police station or to the courts either that's not the only way of you know rectifying things there's a general conversation that is happening and that's great as a start you know
also you know many times you receive emails threatening you death threats especially recent one when you spoke against Salman Khan called him a paper tiger so that time you received many emails you know
I also got lot of invites to be in Big Boss you know with no hold bar that you know kuch bhi you know and anybody would think my team would think wow easy money we can all just go and become you know and the truth is I never do anything to get some financial returns or some great publicity out of it I always speak from my heart I stand by that paper tiger remark saying if you are a youth icon people look up to you and if you're not responsible enough to learn from your past mistakes it's shameful at that you know stage and that you know space that you have reached where you talk to a co-star in that absolutely dismissive manner you talk about co-stars and other industry colleagues who are not even around in a manner which is so demeaning as if the world rotates around your existence and as if you are the sun in the center of the universe you know it's actually very derogatory it sends out a very very bad message about how women are anyway treated in the industry and for me I really don't know the person personally but he seems to do a showcase of everything that is wrong when it comes to toxic male masculinity and every time he does something it gives a great opportunity for the whole country to think about is this the way people should behave and if not let's teach our kids to be better so he gives the exact you know he's writing a book on how not to behave in a sense he's like the great opportunity for a whole country to teach their sons not to be those kind of sons I feel it's really really important that we have more discussions on music than just celebrity culture and you know gossip and tabloid stuff you know we are talking about forums like Oriplast Originals where you see a lot of live instruments and live musicians apart from just the singers dressed up beautifully and I want to take this chance to even put a highlight on the fact that there are a lot of Indian instruments that are dying they're getting extinct just to give you an example my friend you must have all heard of Sir Talveen Singh who is a tabla maestro he's a great producer Mercury Prize winner he's been knighted in the UK of course he lives in the UK he comes every year to make some customized tablas in Mumbai and he was telling me there used to be close to 30-40 tabla makers in Mumbai now there are all of 2 or 3 left because the demand for tablas and playing tablas has only gone down so dramatically people don't want their kids to learn a tabla they rather learn some western instrument or a synth or a drum kit so the fact that these platforms are not only promoting regional music as we said I think all platforms which are promoting instruments is the heritage and the treasure house of our country you know be it a tabla be it a sarangi we have so many instruments and in this song Mon Ke Bajaye in my song it starts with a dotara riff, you know, which can make anybody in any part of the world dance, because it's such a funky and it's so unique and it's so desi and so special to our Indian roots. The other thing which makes me think that we associate all things cool. If you, everybody wants to pick up a guitar and stand like a rock star, that's great. But I think the real cool is the desi cool. I need to in fact work harder in getting more Indian instruments in my band also, because a lot of them, if we don't patronize them, will just die. And in a sense, it's like a small part of your country dying. Because when we are talking about identity, promoting our own traditional values, actually what we should be fighting and protecting and fighting for is these things, you know. Our instruments, our, the musicians who play the instruments, feeling excited that even my child should learn how to play a tabla and not just necessarily a guitar.
So how do we change this? Because, you know, rightly when we initially asked you that, you know, one thing that you want the music industry to have a makeover. Mm-hmm. And now since you mentioned that, you know, Indian instruments are dying. So how can we bring back to life? Because young talents these days are only behind the rap culture or behind, you know, just by hearting all the Eminem raps and all the international raps. But Indian music somewhere is fading away with time.
Indian music will never fade away. That much I can tell you. Because I think my biggest hope comes from the smaller towns. What is really corrupt is bigger cities. Be it, you know, when I go to visit my niece in Hyderabad, to, you know, a kid in Gurgaon, to Mumbai, where everybody thinks they're in New York. They don't realize that when they go to New York, nobody's going to even look at them, because their idea of singing Christina Aguilera or Drake or whatever else that they are mouthing, you know, as a, you know, the tweens I'm talking about. I'm not really clued into what is in at every age group, but everybody wants to feel cool singing. We listen to only English music and we rap and we are hip and cool. So I understand the need to be hip and cool. I think as artists, the responsibility is ours also to make desi cool, you know, and somewhere a platform like this gives me a chance to make desi music very cool. So even in my Coke studio outings, P.S. and Anna is an old, 800-year-old Amir Khusro Kalam. But the fact that it is reinvented, you know, with a band, it becomes relevant and cool for even younger people to listen to it. And they did listen to it. So Katte, when, you know, with Bhamri Devi doing the folk section and hardcore doing, when we create, you know, those kind of fusions, melding of different genres, we make our own, you know, we reinvent our own past, so to say, and make it cool. So it's very important to make music which is relevant and appealing, but for us to just foolishly look towards the West to feel hip, I really feel bad for those kids who are growing up almost like they're like cultural refugees. And it's a very strong word, but that cultural refugees is a word which I hope goes everywhere. Because when we don't have a rooting in our own culture and a love for what is truly our music and our art, hum idhar ke na hain ki udhar ke na, because hum log suddenly jab bahar jayenge, nobody is going to look at us singing, you know, some strange version of the music that we use. Somewhere Indianizing things is something that I take pride in.
Also, you know, the fresh talent that comes from small towns don't make it easily to the industry. So one message that you want to give it to them, do not lose hope.
No, I mean, aise koi lachar wala situation, I think we try to propagate this. Don't lose hope, keep struggling. Yeah, koi zarurat nahi hai. You can be a superstar sitting wherever you are. You don't have to all come here and sleep in the, you know, all those stories and all are really boring. Ki train ke station mein so rahe hain, khaye nahi rahe hain. Sab reality shows mein bhi sab lachari ko hi highlight karte rehte hain. Truth is, ye reality, it's all bullshit. I don't think we need to sing that old rag anymore. Wherever we are, we can be in Lucknow, we can be in Rewa, we can be in Cochin, we can be a superstar in our own mohalla, because honestly there are enough numbers in India to take care of you and make you big. And right now when you have the internet, you have the means of putting out your own stuff, you don't have to come here and chappal ghisao and wait for that one break, which will anyway go to those four people who are part of that clique. So I think India is changing and India is getting this. I think mohalle mohalle mein superstar ho sakta hai, aur yahan pe Bombay mein aake sabko ghisne ki zarurat bhi nahi hai.
Okay.
I don't encourage that for anyone.
Okay. So before we wind up, one message to all the fans across.
Message for all my fans and all the fans of music is look out for things that are honest and truthful. I think you do already. आपको पता चल जाता है. वन थिंग आई लव अबाउट इंडिया इज उनको म्यूजिक की एक्चुअली समझ है. ट्रेंड आके जा सकता है, देर कैन बी सम करंट ट्रेंड चल रहा है, वो दो साल से ज़्यादा चलता नहीं है. यू नो थिंग्स दैट आर टाइमलेस एंड क्लासिक रिमेन फॉर एवर. एंड थैंक यू सो मच फॉर अंडरस्टैंडिंग हु इज़ अ ट्रू आर्टिस्ट एंड वॉट इज़ अ ट्रू मेलोडी. एंड अ सॉन्ग लाइक मुझे क्या बेचेगा रुपया कीप्स गेटिंग मी लव, यू नो. एंड इट इज़ अ इट्स अबाउट अ सीरियस थिंग, देर इज़ नो छिछोरा नाच गान इन इट, बट इट इज़ वन ऑफ माई बिगेस्ट सॉन्ग्स. अभी नहीं आना इज़ अ बैलर्ड ऑफ माइंड विच गेट्स मी सो मच ऑफ लव. सो आई थिंक इंडिया गेट्स मेलोडी वेरी वेल एंड आई एम जस्ट थैंकफुल टू देम. आई होप दे कंटिन्यू टू सपोर्ट एंड बैक ग्रेट लाइव म्यूजिक एंड ऑनेस्ट सॉन्ग्स. Yeah.
So you know, before we wind up, one, if you could just you know sing two lines from Mujhe Kya Bechega Rupay.
Before that, I should sing two lines of that Mon Ke Bojhai, because it's so Mon Ke Bojhai is composed arranged by a brand new composer, upcoming really fresh talent, Gaurav Chatterjee, and written also. I think Roshni Saha has written the Bengali section. She's a singer who had in fact performed with us in Coke Studio. हो हर प्राणी ते मोर बाउल बाजे आलो आलो बाधुर साजे बधुर साजे संगीत श्री हरुणार सोई नाजे मन के बोझाए दोहाई दिए जो तो बुहुया गोरे नजे रोए. लिरिक्स याद नहीं है लेकिन चेक आउट दिस सॉन्ग. इट्स अ ब्रांड न्यू सॉन्ग विद साहिल सोलंकी, composed by Gaurav Chatterjee on Oriplus Originals, SVF Music's brand new platform for great music collaborations. But because you have requested for, I believe, one of my most epic songs, I will sing it for you. Babul pyare sajan sakhare suno meri maiya bojh nahi main kisi ke sar ka naam jhadhar mein naiya patwar banungi लहरों से लड़ूंगी अरे मुझे क्या बेचेगा रुपया हो हो अरे मुझे क्या बेचेगा रुपया.
So this was Sona Mohapatra with us and this is Priyanka Chauhan signing off for now with cameraman Mangesh, India Forums, Mumbai.
Hey guys, check out our revamped website at www.indiaforums.com to get your daily dose of entertainment.
Hi, this is Sona Mohapatra and you're watching me on India Forums.